a lot of people who have that kind of mentality of, oh my gosh, I'm getting the short end of the stick here, you know, and it's, you see it a lot. Quite frankly, it's sad.
Now, a victim complex is really unfortunate. It's like a disability. It really holds people back so much. Now, life is turbulent. There's ups and downs, especially when you're trying to figure the whole thing out. You're gonna have losses. There will be setbacks. But you have to fail. That's how you learn to make adjustments and navigate the whole fucking thing. That is just the nature of it. People with victim mentalities rob themselves of their own failures. There's nothing in failure for them, outside further confirmation that the universe is conspiring against them. Blaming others and outside forces is a huge impediment to growth, because if you did nothing wrong, there's no reason to change. Michael Chandler has taken the time to organize and articulate his thoughts about life. Here he gives a really great description of the major danger of sliding into a victim mentality.
And the third mistake I made was that I found comfort in this pretty little jail cell that we call self-pity. And isn't that what we always do? We find a way to sit there and just talk it over amongst ourselves, by ourselves, in the comfort of our home or our office or our apartment or wherever we are. And the scariest place you can find yourself is actually finding comfort in that jail cell. Now, when we look at this jail cell, obviously, this is where you don't want to find yourself. It's cold, it's hard, it's harsh. The thread count on these sheets aren't exactly Egyptian cotton. The mattress isn't exactly memory foam. So it's not a place that you want to find yourself. Yet when you're sitting in a jail cell like this and that door is locked, there's a lot of freedom and a lot of comfort that comes with just sitting there, because you know it takes a lot more work and a lot more accountability and a lot more striving and a lot more planning to get out of that jail cell, to pull yourself out of it, than it does to just sit there. And the most dangerous place that you can find yourself is actually when you first walk into it. You look at it and you think it's cold, it's harsh, and it's dark, but immediately you start blaming other things, other people, other scenarios, the economy, the competition. You start to blame these things, and all of a sudden the thread count on the sheets starts to feel more like Egyptian cotton, and it starts to feel good on your skin. And then you start to blame your higher-ups or your managers, or for me it was my coaches, or I'll tell you what, if it wasn't for that ref or that judge, if they knew how to judge a fight, I wouldn't be standing here and I would have won that fight and my whole life would have been changed. So then all of a sudden you find yourself on that comfortable Tempur-Pedic mattress of blaming him or blaming her. If she wouldn't have broke my heart, if he wouldn't have broke my heart, if the economy this, the economy that, all of a sudden you start finding more comfort in what was a nasty, cold, dark, harsh jail cell starts to feel like home to you.